It's time for local stories from across the East. Local food. Local fashion. Local businesses. This is your home for local. This is the East's Daily Download on Eastern North Carolina CW.
Hello and welcome to the East Daily Download. My name is Mark. I'll be your tour guide on this adventure across the East today, coming to you on location again from the home office. Hope your day is off to a great start so far. We have a big week of shows in store for you, and we are highlighting all that with graduation celebration as it continues throughout the month. So don't forget, send pictures, send videos of your graduates. They can be high school, they can be college, does not matter. We want to recognize and celebrate them. Okay, today we're going to celebrate a lot on this show. We have a big show in store for you. We've got a lot of cool stories coming your way. So why don't we just dive right in and get going with this? First up, why don't we check in with WNCT 9 on your side anchor Ken Watling in this week's People and Places. And we'll be back in a little bit.
Now downloading People and Places.
Inside this little pink house is a huge piece of Bertie County history.
It just brings back a lot of childhood memories.
The Russells Back in the Day Museum is the culmination of a lifelong dream for curator Russ Russell.
And I just decided I was to start collecting, and one day when I got older, I was going to have my own museum and my own rules and my own style.
His rules, admission is free.
And I've had people that have been by 2 to 3 times already. I opened in June.
His style, nothing is off limits.
If something was going to be hauled off and I saw something I wanted, I would be there to kind of confiscate it with permission.
One man's trash is another man's treasure.
That's exactly right. And it's treasured in here. And if some of these things that I had been going to the landfill, we wouldn't be seeing them today.
And you'll see a little bit of everything here, representing a lot of Bertie County.
When you walk in, do you see certain things that remind you of when you were younger?
Everything. Everything about it. You know, a lot of this predates me. But, for instance, the old movie theater, my grandpa used to take me by there.
76-year-old Jack Williford worked at the Palace Theater back in the day. The memories of that place and many others live on here.
And what we see here, I've experienced it.
What's your favorite part when you walk to this museum?
My favorite part is probably the athletics from Bertie High School.
An entire room dedicated to the football, basketball, and track state championships won by the Falcons over the years. Star athletes who went on to the pros are honored here, too.
I just think it's great because it's accurate, for one thing, and it's intricate on another level.
Another part of Bertie County history is celebrated, Buns Barbecue.
You'll see some of the old counters that we've taken out. You'll see the styles of cornbread pans and the first way we made coleslaw with the hand shredder.
Oh, by the way, Russ's family owns the legendary restaurant.
Buns is work and this is fun.
Yeah, and yeah, I mean, you've been, like you said, you've been collecting pretty much all your life.
All my life.
To get to this point.
To get to this point, right.
It's a unique place for sure, with something for everyone, no matter your age.
I got one section back there that the kids just eyes get this big when they see the wash tub and the old phones, and they get ready to touch something their parents don't touch. I said, let them touch, let them do whatever they want to. It's fine with me.
His rules, his style. The museum is the newest of several in Windsor. Russ invites everyone to visit and make a day of it in Bertie County.
And there's recreational things to do like the canoeing and the kayaking and the zoo. So you can spend a whole day in Windsor. Of course, if you eat at Buns.
WNCT 9 on your side brings you the information you need about the North Carolina reopen phases. Phase 2, statewide stay-at-home order lifted. Restaurants and bars can reopen, dining rooms at limited capacity. People can gather in small groups larger than 10. All businesses and venues can reopen with restrictions. Phase 3, vulnerable people should stay home and avoid crowded spaces. All businesses and venues can increase capacity. Larger groups can gather. Strict rules and restrictions remain for nursing homes and other care facilities. For more information about reopening, visit WNCT.com.
Hey, we're back here on the East Daily Download special graduation celebration month going on right now. So if you have graduates or a graduate and want to recognize them, send your pictures in. Download at WNCT.com is one way you can do it. Also, go into the WNCT.com website. There is a link for graduation, and you can go there and put your picture up. Also, when we're talking about the website, you can also visit WNCT.com for news, local weather, and this show, the East Daily Download. We have a tab that says download. You click on that and you can watch this or any episode of the show. Okay, we still have a lot to get to today. It's still early in the show, so let's get going. And again, graduation celebration is the theme we're going for here. And we'll see pictures of graduates throughout the course of the show. So let's go.
Goose Creek State Park has been very busy this weekend after reopening Friday. Park rangers tell me people are excited to be outdoors and enjoying the campgrounds again.
Awesome. I love it. And so I love running, and it's a beautiful area, and it's great.
Avid runner James Patterson spent his Memorial Day enjoying nature at one of his favorite spots, Goose Creek State Park. State parks reopened Friday as part of Governor Cooper's Phase 2 plan. Park rangers say visitors and campgoers are thrilled to be back.
We have been at full capacity. All of our campsites, all of our cabins, both in the RV cabin campground and in the permanent tent campground, have been completely booked all weekend long.
All trails, tent, RV, and cabin campgrounds and restrooms are completely open, but the visitor center and swim beach areas are closed. Employees are making sure they stay safe and encourage visitors to do the same.
With, you know, lots of people out here where we do have to make direct contact and interactions with people, we're always trying to wear a mask when we do that, or just trying to limit it as much as possible.
All park workers are wearing masks, gloves, and practicing social distancing. Park employees are also limiting their direct interactions with visitors for safety. In Washington, Amber Joseph, 9 on your side.
People in nursing homes can't have in-person visits with families or friends because of the coronavirus, but many facilities are turning to technology to connect their residents with loved ones.
Residents are keeping in touch with family and friends through video programs like Zoom or FaceTime. Their video chat session can last anywhere from a few minutes to a half hour. McGregor Downs bought equipment to allow residents to be connected with loved ones.
We were very fortunate that our company got iPads for us and set up the Zoom account for us. So our Zoom calls go start all the way back early on in like the early part of March.
Workers and other residents help with connections when it's needed. To learn more about virtual visitation, visit WNCT.com and look for our online originals page. In Greenville, Cameron Brewer, 9 on your side.
Together.
Together.
We're all for it.
All for it.
All for acceptance.
Joining forces. Being an ally.
All for expression.
Finding your voice.
Finding yourself.
Finding your power.
All for Mr. Mom.
Miss Save the World.
Or no labels at all. All for showing out.
Standing out.
Coming out.
All for defying stereotypes.
Defying gender types.
Defying whatever you want.
All for we.
All for us.
All for together.
The CW. Dare to defy together.
Oh, hey, welcome back to the East Daily Download. Hope your day and week are off to a great start so far. Hey, you know, one way that you can make sure that your day and week are always off to a great start, you know where I'm going to go with this already if you've seen the show before? The WNCT mobile app. It's a great resource for local news from WNCT 9 on your side, local weather from First Alert Weather Team, and the East Daily Download. We have a tab on there. You can click on it. You can watch the episode that you're watching right now or any episode. It's all great. It's fun. If you're sitting at home and you don't have anything to do, pull up the app. Watch the show. If you are out in the park, maybe do park stuff. But if you have a little bit of downtime, say you're at a store and your spouse is shopping and you're not interested, watch the show. There's a lot of options with this. No one is right, no one is wrong. They're all good options. Okay, speaking of good options, let's see some more graduation celebration pictures coming up in a little bit and check this story out right now.
So Stargirl was inspired by Jeff Johns' real sister, Courtney Johns. She tragically passed away, and in her honor, he created this superhero, Stargirl, which he's written for DC Comics for years, but Stargirl was his first ever superhero to create and establish. And so this is one of his passion projects. So getting to work for him daily and like know that the true inspiration behind her and the meaning behind her has just been so special, and it's been truly an honor.
Yeah, and he had in his office in Atlanta at our sound stages, he had a little picture of her on his desk, and that would always, it was always so nice to see that and to think that, Jeff channeled all that kind of sadness he felt into something really creative, and suddenly, there were hundreds of people kind of, building sets and actors and stunt people and crew people and everyone kind of working on this show that had started, because he was trying to honor his sister. I always loved that idea. And Jeff's such a good guy that, he, like Breck said, like always kind of had it in your mind. So you wanted to do an especially good job.
The first time you're seeing Courtney Whitmore, you're going through her bedroom and you look at her photo wall, or her bulletin board with all her pictures. And there's a picture they actually photoshopped, and it's a picture of me and the real Courtney Johns, and they photoshopped it so beautifully you would never know. It looks like a real photo, and I remember the first time seeing it, and just it's just so surreal seeing like us two next to each other, and then it's in the show, and just the fact that she's also really in it, and it makes sense because she should be, because the only reason we're there is because of her. And yeah. So look out for that little Easter egg picture.
Stargirl, Tuesday at 8 on Eastern North Carolina CW.
If you're a parent who's providing an essential service and need childcare options, call our hotline today at 1-888-600-1685. We'll help you find the childcare you need. Brought to you by the Martin Pitt Partnership for Children.
I'm Gail King, here to say bravo to you, class of 2020. Best of luck to you on the road ahead, wherever your talents may take you, and you know you've all got talents. So this is a deal. This is certainly not the way you wanted to end your school year. We all get that. So how about this? Take a minute to remember all of the good things. You know you had good things. Fun times that you shared with your family and friends. You had a lot of those. And we know that there are big, big things in your future. Did you hear what I said? Big, big, big things. So congratulations, and well done from everyone here at CBS This Morning.
Hey everybody, it's Taylor and Bentley. Tune in to the East Daily Download next week to see more activities with Bentley and I. Make sure to send in pictures and videos of your dogs and pets so we can see what they're up to. Email those at download@wnct.com. See you guys next time.
What made Steve say?
I needed that laugh, man. You're driving naked. Cops pull you over. What you hope they don't ask you to do?
Bend over.
I needed that laugh, man. I can't bend over, Steve.
Family Feud. Weeknights at 7:30 on WNCT, 9 on your side.
Ariana Grande teamed up with Lady Gaga for the weekend's big hit, Rain On Me. The first collaboration between the superstar artists hit YouTube as the weekend began and shot to number one on the trending chart with nearly 40 million views in less than 48 hours. It seems the coronavirus can't stop the world's longest-running film festival. The governor of Italy's Veneto region says the Venice Film Festival will take place as scheduled September 2nd through the 12th, though likely with fewer films than usual. It would be the first major movie industry event not postponed or canceled since the pandemic hit. I'm a tie-tie-coon, that's why they hate me. Till they throw the sheets, I'm going crazy. The future is now. High Off Life is the seventh album by the rapper Future to top the Billboard 200 album chart. It debuted at number one with the equivalent of 153,000 units sold, his biggest week ever. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
For those in need, there's never been a greater time of need. Join the Salvation Army in our fight to bring hope to those in our community struggling the most. Drop off your donation today at a local Eastern North Carolina chapter or give at salvationarmycarolinas.org.
Well, that's going to do it for this episode of the East Daily Download. As always, thank you so much for joining us. We know you have a lot of options, and we appreciate you taking the time to be with us. We always try to bring you the best show possible. And again, throughout the course of this month, we're doing graduation celebration, recognizing and honoring college and high school graduates here in Eastern North Carolina. And in honor of that, today I have on the mortarboard, and because it's the end of the show and I got through the show, I will turn it to this side So I've graduated from this episode. We invite you to graduate this episode and come back for the next episode. We'll call the next episode Graduate School. And also, I want to just tease something. Coming up on Wednesday, we'll have a very special new thing that we're going to be doing throughout the course of the summer. So stick around Wednesday. Come back on Wednesday. I mean, come back tomorrow on Tuesday, but come back on Wednesday also so you can see what we are doing. We're getting out of the studio for something special. Okay, with all that said, I'm out of here. Have a great day. I'll see you real soon on the East Daily Download. Dun, 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 dun.
Tomorrow, when we hit the road for the next edition of the East Daily Download, we're headed to the three C's for this week's Down Eats. Graduation Celebration Month continues as we recognize more local graduates from across the East, and we'll introduce you to a Southern star. So join us tomorrow for the East Daily Download on Eastern North Carolina CW.